Hello dear students, welcome to chemistry class. In this class we are discussing one of the named rearrangement or reaction, that is a Claisen rearrangement, and this rearrangement is an intramolecular rearrangement of allyl aryl ethers to ortho or para substituted allyl phenols on heating. This Claisen rearrangement is an intramolecular rearrangement which involves the conversion of allyl aryl ethers to ortho or para substituted phenols on heating. For this I will take one simple example of an allyl aryl ether, O CH2 CH double bond CH2. This on heating, and what is its name? Allyl phenyl ether. This group CH2 double bond CH single bond CH2 is an allyl group, and this one is an phenyl group, and it is of the formula ROR dash, therefore it is an ether, allyl phenyl ether. This on heating undergoes intramolecular rearrangement according to the Claisen rearrangement and forms CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2, forms an ortho allyl phenol. Ortho allyl phenol, see here this OH group is a functional group and this one becomes a substituent, and this allyl group is present at the ortho carbon of this OH group, therefore it is named as ortho allyl phenol. This rearrangement is called what? Claisen rearrangement. And here one point we should keep in mind, that it is an intramolecular rearrangement, therefore the most expected product is an ortho substituted product, but if the ortho positions, both the ortho positions are blocked, then only we will accept para allyl phenol. Okay, and coming to the mechanism, CH2 CH CH2, okay, and here this oxygen is having two lone pairs of electrons, and we know that the oxygen is more electronegative than the carbon, therefore it will drag this bonded pair of electron towards this oxygen carbon single bond, and as this carbon now it is having only four bonds, then after this it will get five bonds and becomes unstable, therefore it will donate this pi bond towards this carbon, and this carbon becomes unstable with the extra bond, and it will donate this pi bond towards this carbon-carbon single bond. On heating, this intramolecular rearrangement takes place, which results in the formation of O H CH2 CH double bond CH2. Okay, then now this oxygen is having an extra pair of an electron, will drag this proton, and this bond will back donate towards the benzene ring, and this bond will move towards the oxygen. OH CH2 CH double bond CH2. Okay, and here we are getting ortho allyl phenol, and we have started with allyl phenyl ether. Okay, this rearrangement is called what? Claisen rearrangement. And here one thing we have to keep in mind, that the carbon which is attached to the oxygen is not attaching to an ortho position. See here, here the carbon which is attached to the oxygen is not attaching to a ortho position or a para position of the benzene ring, or the para carbon or ortho carbon of the benzene ring. See here, this carbon which is far away or which is not attached to the oxygen is connecting to ortho carbon atom. Okay, yes, by this example you can O CH2 CH double bond CH CH3, okay, and this is also an allyl group, and after the heating this undergoes intramolecular rearrangement. OH CH CH double bond CH2 CH3 see here. This ortho carbon is now connecting with this carbon, not with this carbon. Okay, then looking at other examples, as I already told, if the ortho positions are blocked, that means the compounds of this type O CH2 CH double bond CH2 here at one position of the, or at one side of this group, that is at this ortho position, already one substituent is there. Therefore, the intramolecular rearrangement can now move towards this ortho position or at the para position. Then here we will accept this one, CH3 OH CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2. This is the expected product. Then if O CH2 CH double bond CH2 CH3 if both the para positions are blocked, then the intramolecular rearrangement will move towards the para carbon. OH CH3 CH3 CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2. Okay, these are some of the examples for a Claisen rearrangement. And this Claisen rearrangement is also called 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Then what is mean by this 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement? See here. Here I am writing that allyl phenyl ether CH2 CH CH2. Correct? This one is CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2. And in the reaction mechanism, as we have seen, this bond, the oxygen and the carbon which is attached to the oxygen bond is breaking, that is this bond is breaking, and I will start numbering from this bond in both side, 1 2 3, 1 2 3. Here 3 atoms are involving in an rearrangement, and here also 3 atoms are involving in an rearrangement. And here we will observe that this third carbon of this side is forming a new bond with the carbon which is numbered as 3 in the benzene ring. And here we are getting the product as OH CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2. Correct? Then now, as here the formation of new sigma bond taking place between the 3,3 position of both the sides, we can call this one as a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Okay, this is all about the Claisen rearrangement. Thank you.